Hello, everybody, and welcome to Crystal River Romp, Episode 2, Sorcerer's Apprentice. Last time, Simba bribed a raccoon. What will happen today on Crystal River Romp?
Ah, yes.
They're not wrong.
Spectre, files in hand, just kind of grumbling, looking at a watch. The dark office kind of just steps forward.
Nimbus said you would be here, but you're not here, I don't think. Hello?
And as Spectre steps into the main portion of the room, a light comes on.
Well, of course I'm here. Don't bother with that malarkey. No, come closer. I'm not coming out of my cage. I have not been doing fine. I'm so stressed, as you can see. Yeah. Go on with yourself, stop story. Are you going to listen to the actual important thing that I need to tell you about? Of course, Spectre. What else would I do?
Spectre just sets a handful of files on the table.
Well, I'm going to need you to do plenty. In like an hour and a half? Maybe an hour 45. How does that sound? I guess I could. Do you know what park they're going to be in? Probably Wizardtopia. I don't see why they would go anywhere else, really. I will let you know, though. We've been having some issues. I'm going there myself, I think. That's what Cloud9 said. Of course I'm going to watch the spectacle. Mostly from a distance. I will page you. Listen, Warden, I know you are busy and I know you like your dramatics, but you need to take this seriously. We may have people trying to invade the park and overthrow us, which would not be good, now would it? And the Warden in the birdcage. Fine, I guess. Whatever you say, I guess. I wouldn't want anyone throwing me out of my throne, after all. Yeah. Okay, whatever. Lead over the files. Be close enough is where you can do the thing. I'm going back to my laboratory. Goodbye.
And the figure steps down from the cage and adjusts her hair, making sure it's perfect, flat, straightens out her clothes.
Oh, Pepper, what kind of hooligans have you summoned this time?
After all of you have arrived in Misney Park, things were a little bit rocky at the start, what with finding a deranged baseball player torturing someone tied to a batting machine, and, well, someone who had the ability to basically make balls into miniature missiles, but the four of you got through it more or less unscathed. Now, about an hour later, at a setup shop in Misney Park of the classic food chain of the Misney company Rat Burger, all four of you are sitting at a table discussing matters. Feel free to say what you're having, if you're eating anything, and the floor is yours.
Ruth is eating he's eating spaghetti. He has topsy-turvy day off at the current moment because he's taken a somewhat of a break from that stand.
I see that, December.
December, what are you doing? Don't bother this poor wizard man.
Once upon December, seeing the fancy wizard man is just messing with his hat.
The wizard man, working as a clerk at this rat burger, assumes it's just the wind.
Minerva would just be sipping on some shitty coffee that she had gotten there. It's not much, but it's caffeine, so she doesn't care in the slightest. She is... You can't really tell what's happening. You can't even tell if she's thinking right now. She just looks tired.
Ruth will bring out the business card for Dolly and Minerva, introducing himself.
Minerva just kind of snaps into reality for a second when the card enters her peripheral vision. She looks over, sees the card, like, spends 2 seconds too long staring at it, and she's like, thank you. She takes it, and she, like, sleepily reads it.
Ruth brings out a pen and paper, writes down to Minerva, are you doing well?
I'm doing as well as I guess I can. It's not much of a problem. Just don't worry about me.
Ruth nods because he's not gonna touch that.
Christ. Dolly, what? I gotta ask. What? Why did you think we were in Paris?
That's a funny story. You ever heard of a boat?
Yes, I know what a boat is.
You ever heard of a gun?
You have 2 of them in your legs. I don't think that would be a problem.
Well, I used to have 5 more.
Where would you hold them?
In the boat?
She stares at you for a second before just slamming her head into the table and groaning.
Okay. Oh, anymore?
Ruth pats her back slightly.
I hate everything.
What I do like, though, look at this. She's gonna point to a lemonade here that she's got from the clerk. It's like, it's got one of those umbrellas in it, but instead of like an umbrella, it's got a little wizard out on the top.
Just lemonade with ace.
It's pretty nice, I guess.
I know, right?
So, anything new happening to you, Dolly? Anything interesting? Anything crazy, I guess?
I lost 5 shotguns.
That's kind of a given with the fact that I'm guessing your boat sank. I'm sorry about your boat, I guess. Like, it's a boat. I don't know how you got here, though. How did you get here?
On the boat?
What? Where is the boat, then?
You ever heard of the Atlantic Ocean?
Of fucking course I have.
Somewhere over there.
Ruth actually remembered something. He then scribbled out Dolly being wet before when they met.
Did you at least park it somewhere where you wouldn't get arrested again? You have gotten arrested for a lot of things.
There ain't no law at sea, Mimi.
Thank God. I don't... Do you need help getting back to... wherever the hell you were going? I'm sure my uncle could help with that, like always.
Nah, I think I'll just stick here.
Okay then. So, I got to ask, who are you two? We didn't exactly have time to introduce ourselves with how crazy it got so fast, but...
Ruth points at the business card that has his name on it.
She looks down and she's just like, oh, that's what that was for. Sorry. She reads over again because the first time she read it, she didn't even process it. She just skipped it and was just like, eh.
Ruth Steelburn, wandering clown.
What? Okay. Do you have... are you employed here, or were you just here as a guest.
Ruth thought about it for a moment. How did he get his ticket, he thought.
Is that a me question I hear?
Yes.
Okay. well... Fuck, you like, it's so much harder for me to answer this question in regards to Ruth than it is for the other two, and then Simba didn't have one. Would you say that you had at least a mailing address?
Well, yeah. I mean, technically, so far as his person goes, he technically does get mail meant by his stand technicality.
I can see that actually working that way. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Suddenly just like a mail bus like springs out of the ground and you got it.
Yep, basically.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's how it happened.
Ruth pulls out another paper. He states that he got his ticket by mail. Not sure from who or why, but he got it. So he decided to take a vacation here.
I'm more confused about you, she stares at Simba in his very tribal outfit. Are you a cosplayer or something, or is that just your clothes?
I usually wear these clothes. My name is Simba and Mseleku. You probably heard me say it multiple times.
How exactly did you get here? I don't know if they would let you in with that kind of clothes on. It just seems strange.
Ruth points to himself.
At least you're covered. He has half his body, just not.
Ruth rolled his eyes.
She has a look of realization and just kind of just, excuse my manners, but I forgot to introduce myself before. My name is Minerva Minniti. And, December. December, messing about with the, pizza boxes, kind of looks up real fast, just like, oh shit, and like, it goes over here and stands behind Minerva and gives a very, graceful, bow. Like, you would expect, like, in a show a noble woman would give, but knowing its personality, it doesn't feel right. And this is my stand once upon a December. I just call it December to make it simpler. So, very simply, what exactly are your plans here after, well, that mess? Since, well, with a fight like that, I doubt it's a one-time kind of occurrence.
I don't know exactly. I don't even know how I got here in the first place.
Okay, I'm not going to question that. And Christ. I ask that because with the fact that we had that fight before, we're probably going to run into more from what I know. The world's never nice.
Ruth places that on the table as he looks at it for a moment. Eddie taps the mask and looking at everyone else. The mask just appeared out of nowhere.
Is that your stand?
Sort of nods.
I don't know how you can not, I don't know how you can have a stand, but, Christ.
It's kind of creepy, isn't it?
Riff points at his face.
No offense.
Simba, your name, right?
Yes.
Do you have physical form for your stand, or?
I think so.
You think so?
I don't think so. Not sure.
You don't think so. Okay.
Wasn't Simba the one that doesn't know what a stand is? I don't remember.
He knows what stands are, but he doesn't know. They don't know that people can have stands. He thought was just normal, was just an everyday occurrence.
Oh my god.
God. Dolly, can you? She stares at Dolly. Can you make a line? She holds her hand out, Dolly, just staring at her.
Yeah, sure.
no.
Oh my god.
Not that line, Jesus Christ. I meant of communications.
Oh. Yeah, I can do that. I'm going to reach into my pocket, and I'm going to hand something over to Minerva.
Oh.
Minerva's going to take the thing, and I am going to set a secret action.
Secrets, I see. All right.
Well, what should we do next, specifically? Should we just split up and never see each other again by, I guess, the will of whatever fate is making this happen, or are we just going to continue exploring around and seeing how fast we run into a battle?
Judging by what happened last time, I'd say that speaking up is not wise.
And that just break my heart.
Why not just enjoy the park?
All of you do know, in the regards to, like, the map of the park, you just came from the batting cages. Up to your north is a bumper car area, and over to the right, I believe, leads to a fountain? Fountain Park? Something along those lines.
Ruth makes a suggestion to the bumper cars. It's probably going to be a best idea to unwind after that battle. So, Ruth, this looks at Minerva, Dolly, and Simba, and points to the bumper cars.
Minerva is looking past Simba and is just staring out over here. Over this way. She doesn't seem to be processing anything else right now. She's just staring.
Simba looks behind him and sees the two guards. The two guards walking towards them.
No, they're not really walking towards you. They both seem to have, like, holding their hands on their caps, and you hear just kind of a hushed conversation between the two of them.
Try and eavesdrop.
Ooh, eavesdropping. I think that would be a brain troll.
That was crap.
Can Once Upon December go up behind them and, like, try to whack off one of their hats?
Simba, Ruth, neither of you particularly can pick up on their conversation. They seem to be muffling it so that as they pass by, no one would hear what they say. Once Upon a December, you knock off Hoss's hat. It just kind of falls on the ground.
What the fuck?
Hmm. Strong winds today?
It dives into
I guess. I think there's a front coming through.
Del Toro leans down and picks it up and hands it over to you.
Thanks. Come on, let's go.
Which way do those kids go? This way?
Maybe.
Yeah, we can probably use the back way.
Yeah.
Once Upon a December looks like it would probably be giggling if it had a voice. It died. It dove into a bush when it thwacked off his hat like a little kid would.
Ruth just seems a little bit sad that they're going to the bumper cars because that's a probable bad thing of an omen there.
Ah, yes, an omen.
An omen?
Frogs? Frogs?
Yeah, they just seem to be Misney Park security guards. That's what they looked like to you guys. They head off towards the bumper cars.
Basically, puts his hand to his face and mumbles to himself, I wonder who they were looking for.
Did Ruth hear the part about looking for a kid with a 9?
You all did because Once Upon a December distracted them in such a regard that they forgot to lower their voices.
Okay, so Ruth reiterates about something about they are looking for a kid. Maybe some troublemaker kid.
They're looking for kids.
A group of kids.
I mean, it's not our job. It's not. It's just their job. There might be just some troublemakers around here. This park is massive. There are lots of people.
Ruth writes down, remember the last time someone was doing their job and then all of a sudden they attacked someone?
Well, did we see any crystals on them, or is that just...
Didn't see any crystals
like
on them.
Security guard.
Yeah, security. Just look like security guard.
I'd rather not be paranoid about every person that has a rat badge in here, and it's a lot of stress.
Ruth then nods, and then writes down if Dolly, Minerva, or Simba want to do anything while they're here. It's a good time to relax for now.
Are we just gonna sit here in silence and ponder over our own deaths for all year? Or are we actually going to talk here?
I think I'm about to go into the park.
You're about to go to park? What?
Park, park. That place. That place literally right over here. Over that way.
What's a part of December doing?
It saw a pretty sign. It's going up to touch pretty sign.
Electrocute the sand.
Yeah, what's a part of December roll durability?
Oh god! Jesus.
Never mind, you're fine. Never mind, you're fine.
Fine.
You're fine.
What?
I rolled all ones. You're fine.
Okay.
You're fine.
That was all ones.
Dang, it has a D
oops,
in
all ones.
You, so.
Tally, yeah, oops, all ones.
Oops, all ones. Once upon a December, you get a little pssst, but you pull your head away quick enough before anything happens.
He kind of looks a little bit surprised, and then it just kind of stares at its hand that, like,
oh, really yeah, got you cry. Definitely short-circuited the sign, though.
Oh, god damn it. What's the point? Stepford, like, jumps back a little bit, accidentally short-circuited the sign, just like, oh shit, and it dives into a bush again. Minerva hears this, and she just knows, and she just cups her hands in her head and takes a very deep sigh.
Puts on the mask of topsy-turvy day. Almost like a split second, you don't see him there, but then back. The sign's working again.
What?
Did Ruth just go fix the sign?
In a very incredible fast speed, I might add.
How did you fix the sign? Explain that.
He just put a hammer that says fix it.
Okay, roll precision.
Meet the inner god.
Well, you get half of it working. For some reason, no light's coming out of it, though.
I guess we won't have to pay for that now, maybe? I don't know.
You know, that's funny, because that's not scientifically possible.
What?
Drugs as he taps his mask. He just comically just pulled out a sign out of his left sleeve. And that's how I work.
So I don't think I've introduced myself yet, have I?
You haven't.
Sorry, I was eating ice cubes.
Me too!
The same.
Ice! Don't you have a problem with being cold?
I like the pain.
Is that okay, Edgelord look at Simba?
Dolly, uh-huh. Talk about this, please.
Do you think I'm cool yet, Minerva?
Eating ice doesn't make you cool.
Yes, it does.
No, it does not. It just makes you sick and then you die. Jesus Christ.
It does?
But I love.
Hey, Minerva, roll brains to convince Dolly that eating ice kills you.
Oh god!
Oh damn! Shit, dude.
No! No!
Rip Dolly.
Really?
Oh, thanks for having me, everyone.
Fucking Dolly, signs no. Out.
Dolly, no, stop.
Can't stop being dead, Minerva.
Dolly, you're literally talking to me. You're not dead.
But you wouldn't lie to me.
Eating ice is an instant.
We've played along with this with a side. How could you kill your aunt?
What? No! Stop! Eating ice isn't instant death? Jeez. What? No!
Oh, so it's like a slow burn, but cold.
I guess, yeah, sure, let's go with that. Can you stop?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, God.
That was easy.
Anyway, where was I before I died? So hey, I'm Dolly. Minerva's already mentioned me. I'm her aunt, you know? I'm also a stand user of many, many many stands, you know.
Well, hello, Dolly.
Roll credits.
Mimi, they ain't mentioning the hats.
They all have hats, though.
Yeah, they ain't mentioning a single one of them.
Well, they're all pretty hats. I guess they're all pretty...
Yeah, but I want them to say it.
Ruth just pulled out a piece of paper. Sorry, I'm mute. I can't usually use my voice at the current moment.
Mm. Oh, sorry.
Dobby, can you get off the table?
I'm not on the table.
You're on the table.
They're on the table.
Dolly unknowingly climbed onto the table.
In your excitement, you find yourself... What's that under your feet? Is that wood?
If there's nothing anyone else wants to talk about, I'm going to go throw away my cup now. She has an empty cup of coffee that she is going to go throw away. Where is the trash can?
Well, there's a bin right here.
Oh, I can see it. Okay. She goes over, checks the coffee cup and the trash. After closing it, she, like, stands there staring at the coffee can. She's obviously, like, processing what just happened and just trying to figure out what to do next. And then, like, she gets something and she just wanders this way.
What did we say about not splitting up?
She snaps out of a daze, looks around, she looks back and she's like, oh shit, sorry.
If that's comedically impossible, looks like he's getting on the air a little bit. Like an actual impressive mime, like he's getting into a car.
Oh my god.
Are you getting an invisible car?
Yes.
Oh my god. Are you gonna drive through the tables?
Driving himself around.
You can just use your imagination for this. Pretend that this is like slightly transparent.
Riff hawks so hard you guys can hear it.
I'm not getting into that car.
Gotta hand it to him. Not a bad mime at all.
I'm going to stop questioning things now.
Can I get in?
You actually feel the car being there.
Wow.
Meow.
He's going to follow, like, Minerva, but the car is
straight through the crowd. Can I get a cup of coffee?
Oh yeah, sure.
He reaches down and pulls up.
Here you go, ma'am.
She pays for it, takes it, and just continues back this way, sipping it.
The fucking mime-mobile?
Hey, I'm walking here.
It's going backwards.
Yep. How else do you drive as a mime?
Probably, like, getting so many weird looks, like, what the fuck?
Alright, you guys are all going off towards bumper cars?
Hell yeah. We're taking a real car into bumper cars. Time to kill some children.
Oh my god, Ruth has, like, his own... Fuck, the kids are gonna die, guys. Alright, you guys continue towards the bumper cars.
Oh, I love this song.
God, this song.
What to think?
There's more wizards!
No! I think of it.
The wizards are actually the, here, hold on. This is Enrio Grande. This is his old ancestor,
Oh no!
This is Grandios Canyon!
Oh my god!
There you go.
Oh my god!
This somehow, I don't know how, but I would say this technically activates a secret action of mine.
What?
What? Excuse me?
No, explain what?
This technically activates a secret action that I call, because we're frenemies.
What?
God.
If Simba sees Rio Grande, I will spend a plot point to make them both enemies.
Oh my god!
Because it's a secret action, I'm gonna let you do that without a plot point.
Fuck! Yeah.
Oh my fucking god, I'm so sad. Okay. We gotta change this up real quick.
Oh my god.
I think I have a good.
You got a good song for it? Okay, cool. Simba, you see these angled shoulders. This man. You know this man. That's Grandiose Canyon!
Grandiose!
Oh? He turns over his back shoulder.
Simba!
He hops the line, jumps down.
My lad, it's been, what, 10, 20 years?
10, I believe.
Time eludes me.
He flexes his hand.
What brings you to this land of misfortune and misery?
He puts a finger at his chin.
Well, I did ask you the same thing.
Oh, a reversal. But please, I insist.
He gestures. I asked you first.
Well.
Goodbye, Minerva. Minerva saw the first sentences of that, just like, fuck it. Just fucking leaving.
I'm gonna roll health for Grandiose Canyon real quick. Do you want to do like a quick 1v1?
Are you trying? Oh my god.
Well, you see, I don't know how I even got here in the first place.
A likely story. You expect me to believe that bullshit, Mseleku?
Mseleku.
I don't give a shit.
He takes a step forward. All the other people in line are just kind of staring.
Last time I saw you was in Egypt.
Oh, really? You got any proof for that, tribe man?
I do. It's been a 4.4 something. Brings out one thing. And it's teddy bear!
His teddy bear?
It's a teddy bear. Of. Well, the thing he got was Anubis. Bear of Anubis.
It's a teddy bear that looks like Anubis?
Yes.
I love the rest of the party fucking leaving.
Yeah, I love the clown card just being like, nope.
Everyone's in the car!
Taking a defensive car position. Oh fuck, what are we doing?
What?
I see the car going forward. What are we doing?
Are we gonna run over Simba and Grandiose
Canyon? There's
a reason he's not around! He got run over by a clown car.
He looks to his side. He sees basically in his eyes a bunch of people sprinting by.
What an odd formation. That man with his hands. Could it be?
Grandiose is gonna monologue at you.
Is that a weird sort of cross-country team?
You're shaking!
He shakes his head.
No,
couldn't be. It's the wrong season. I almost forgot my quarry! He turns back around. Simba! Don't think I've forgotten you!
Simba.
Don't tell me that you're still playing with those kids' toys.
He takes steps forward, towering above you, gets way too close to your personal space.
Something. Feels something. He just activated. Menacing aura!
Did Simba get his own menacing aura?
That's a trait! And it feels more menacing than his. You sure about that? I'm pretty sure. Do you know that this is yours? Hands it to him.
What? This cannot be.
Memory flashback, real quick. Grandiose Canyon remembers his childhood.
What?
He shakes his head. Well, it doesn't matter. And then he punches you with the plushie.
Oh, I'm just going to do one thing. Let's roll my durability. Because this thing only punching me.
Just take it on the chest.
I'm because I'm literally stunned.
Oh, hold on. I'm going to minus one because he's literally punching you with a plushie. So that's a six. Yeah, he punches your chest. Looks at his hand. Bone cracking sound. Rio, or Grandiose Canyon has taken six damage.
my perfectly manicured fingernails! You pay for this, Simba! This won't be the last time you've heard of Grandiose Canyon!
He fucking runs.
Is he gonna run into the car? Aw.
Yes.
He dodges the- What the fuck is happening over here?
Dolly, what are you doing?
Dolly! Wait.
He looks at Dolly.
Excuse me. I know that you're trying to do cross-country here, but please, I am making a getaway!
He runs and leaps.
Riff just hands him a bunch of bandages for his hand.
Oh, thank you.
He takes them.
There he goes!
I thank you for that, assassin, oh my god!
I literally didn't expect that!
I can't believe that happened!
Rift just looks at the crowd, bows, and does a cheerily dance as he's going towards Simba.
This one girl claps, the rest of them turn back to bumper cars and start shuffling in.
Bumper cars!
Where did Minerva go?
Where did Minerva go?
She fucking left out of the splash zone or whatever the fuck that was.
Oh, she went down, she's down here out. By the bagpipes.
Yeah. She's just kind of looking around at all the shit around here. And she's like, what the fuck?
Pats and Simba's shoulders like, you did well.
Yeah, sorry about that. I have a history with him.
Ruth, did look at Minerva and Dolly, looks at the bumper cars. He shrugs, going into the line.
Hell yeah.
Simba is just going to walk towards the bench instead.
Fair enough.
Minerva's gotta be looking around everything around here, just the mess of stuff, and she looks over across the bumper cars, and she looks a bit up at this balcony up here. It's a bit strange.
Oh, yeah.
And just, does she see anything up there? Because it's a pretty strange added to this whole thing.
Yeah, it seems to just be a balcony. There's like a door in the back. Seems to go down into this building.
There. Just all the random shit around here, and she kind of mumbles to herself, did this end up doing this? Like, seems like the type of thing you would do.
Ruth smiles and waves.
Hello. Present your ticket, and welcome to the Grand Magic Kart Racing!
Keep all hands and feet inside the vehicle at all times.
Doesn't understand, and hands over his red ticket.
Ah! He, like, scans it over with a, like a little beeper. You hear a click. He steps aside and lets you in.
I love that these are, like, actual cars.
Yeah, look, I didn't have a bumper car, is it?
We've taken the purple one.
Welcome to Wizard's Bumper Cars.
I'm gonna hand in my red ticket as well.
Click. Step.
Oh, God.
I love Dolly and her conglomerate.
Sunday clothes go beep.
Beep.
Well, the timer goes off. Bumper cars begins. Ruth and Minerva, you two can watch. Is there anything you'd like to do to react to bumper cars starting, or just want to watch? God, help me move people and make it look. Yeah! Thank you.
Once upon a December, just sitting on the top of this ladder over here and just watching the mess of all the cars. Minerva hearing the sounds of. Thing starting is gonna start walking over this way. I'm guessing there's like a small alley here?
Yeah, there is.
You wouldn't hear it. Because I'm stealing all the sass.
Of course you are.
I called it!
Yep, she's, you may do that.
She's gonna start shimmying across, just... Oh, a piano. Interesting.
And, how much do I get?
Let's say that from this bumper car game, you gain a total of 4 points that you can distribute however you want.
Is someone cooking something here?
That's definitely a pot of soup. On like a generator next to is that the Ark of the Covenant?
Huh. What the fuck?
Makes sense. Then there are two ones.
Who decorated this place?
Oh, we both grabbed the same person. One.
He glitches out of the matrix. He's free.
Can Ruth is like, wait, why is this guy?
This guy is fucking dead. He can run over. He scrambles back in. There's like a whistle blow. A wizard like runs in. Is like, waves his hand. Sees him get back in. Nods his head. Does the like, I see you eye motion.
My mistake.
She climbed up this ladder to go on the roof.
You did, my fucking god. You're up here on the roof.
Just fucking ladder. Let's go over here.
Go on an adventure. Simba, I'm gonna check in with you. How's the bench going?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
I was grabbing!
I didn't know I would do that! I'm so sorry!
Oh, yeah. The car! They're coming to get me! No.
I love that everyone saw that too.
I'm guessing she was a victim of the Dolly Bam, just getting slammed by all the sound points.
Yeah, Simba, you see bumper cars. There's a knife and a spoon next to you. You look behind you, there's a poster on the wall. Oh, that's neat.
Jesus.
Okay. Simba just looks down and basically then an animal pops up. Raccoon.
Oh fuck, here we go.
Trash panda!
He looks up at you.
You again?
How's it going?
Good.
Got any more pizza?
Unfortunately, no.
That's lame.
But!
Turns its head, looks back.
I do have this. And basically opens up a packet of crisps.
Grabs bag.
Once upon a December before, went to this vending machine, stole something, and just gave one of the things that stole to you.
Oh, perfect. And the timer rings for bumper cars. Jesus!
Hey, no,
Jesus! No, Sunday close!
Oh, Dolly is in the corner dead. This guy is passed out in his car. Ruth looks like he's on a pile of bodies.
Oh god, Sunday Close has so many points!
One of the people is literally trapped underneath the car.
Sunday Close, no!
People start hopping out of their cars.
Yeah, Sunday Close clone over here gives it to Dolly.
I was just putting Minerva, like, sitting on the edge of the roof, just looking out across everything and just watching what's going on.
Oh, okay. Wonderful. So, everybody, we're gonna head back. All of you spend time and enjoying yourselves at the Wizard's Bumper Cart attraction. Some of you participating, others of you talking to raccoons or sitting on rooftops. About an hour passes, and the sun is starting to go down as... you all get done with a rather fun day.
Make sure that Minerva's right next to him is like, okay, Missy, you're going to enjoy fun and you're going to like it.
She's up on a roof.
That doesn't stop him.
Minerva is over on a roof.
Yeah, she's just chilling there.
That's not safe, Mimi, and you know that.
And what are you gonna do? Stop me?
Yes.
Ruth gets a very long broom, just starts poking at Minerva.
You talking about what's upon December? Minerva's all the way over here.
Minerva's just leaving, I guess.
Minerva's vibing. She goes over to the other place farther away from the people who are trying to get her off the roof. He's just staring out at the rest of the park, just looking at all the lights and just kind of taking a second to look over everything.
Honestly, in the nighttime, the park, all the lights of the rides and everything you've just experienced so far, it's rather beautiful. And this is a good vantage point to look at it.
It'll go to Simba. He looks like he could use some company.
But he has the raccoon.
The raccoon hisses at you, Ruth. And like hops back up on top of the rooftops.
Nothing stole a Sunday class.
Right in raccoon. It's okay. I have pizza.
You write in raccoon? The raccoon doesn't understand that.
He has pizza. He said he has pizza.
He looks at the mime. Raccoon does not trust. Raccoon stay.
Ruth just spawns out a pizza out of his chest.
Raccoon is tentatively trustful. He jumps down and lands on the pizza.
Let the raccoon have it.
What's going down with Dolly and Minerva down here?
Dolly is chasing Minerva. Minerva's not having it.
No, you need adult supervision to be up here.
You guys are chasing each other on the rooftops, fucking hell.
Offers a soda to Simba.
Thank you. Takes it and opens it up and then drinks it.
He pulls up the sign saying, what was that all about by that weird looking badass guy?
Oh, Andios, he's kind of... me and him are kind of rivals of sorts. It's more say frenemies than anything.
Ruth nods and understands, says he looks slightly towards Dolly and Minerva. Kind of feels a little bit out of place about the around the group, but then again, he's used to it.
He looks overseas, Minerva caught by Sunday clothes, and Dolly's sprinting down the roof trying to catch her.
Ruth falls up. Minerva's like a cat.
And as the night goes on, you will enjoy this moment, but it's odd. You're aware of everything thus far. You have been through the park, you've seen all the park goers, so why isn't anyone coming to tell you that it's too late to go home?
Not again.
Oh, fuck. Dolly, can you let me go? Jesus.
Okay.
Pulls up a very large sign for Minerva and Dolly. Get down from the roof before I drag you down.
Right. How tall are these boxes over here?
There's about 5 feet off the ground. You could probably hop to them and be fine.
Yeah, she's jumping down onto these and then hopping down. Once Pot Sebru's flying over.
Ruth brings a soda can towards Minerva.
In a minute. She's gonna walk over here.
Mm-hmm.
She's gonna look out that way. Some people went that way before, right?
Some people did. You remember back? Who was that? You saw someone walking down this direction. Weird cap, blue hair. Oh.
Yes.
The Misney Park guards. This place is off limits. It seems to be under construction. If you had to guess, this is a, you can see, like, metal beams and, like, planks of wood. If you had to guess, that leads over to a unfinished roller coaster.
Huh. Okay, then.
Ruth's handing the can of soda towards Dolly.
What kind of soda?
He didn't know what you wanted for a soda, so he just decided to get you a cherry soda.
Good enough.
And all of you guys, you start to hear something. Maybe feel something? A little bit of, like, a rumbling going through the floor underneath your feet. As you look around you in the darkness, the lights of the park silhouetting it, it's all around you. Every single corner of the horizon, the sky, everything, as a massive cage starts to come down on the park.
What?
Ruth gets a very long hook, like, you know those, like, stage hooks? He's going to grab Minerva and pulls her close, just on the off chance.
She's all the way over there.
Is that within your stance range?
It's Jeez. Within its stance capability, but not its stance range.
I am going to say that Minerva has the opportunity to avoid this if she doesn't want to get into it.
She's definitely avoiding that.
Okay. Yeah, you hear just a big whoomf as the massive park-wide cage lands on the ground.
Nani!
That ain't good.
Ruth shakes his head on Minerva.
She's too busy being shocked at the sky to see what's going on.
Minerva, you're shocked at the sky. You, sweating nervously, looking around you. For a moment, you look back. You hear a pew! You look back at Dolly and Ruth. And your eyes go wide as something out of the sky lands mere inches away from them, sending up a cloud of smoke and with a detonating cacophonous explosion.
Oh boy.
Dolly, you are knocked backwards. Ruth, you're not knocked anywhere, but there's a burn mark on the ground from an explosion.
Ruth's gonna look to the sky, wondering where that came from as...
And at this point, everyone, I'd like you to roll initiative.
Boom on the secret action.
Alright. Yeah, by the way, Minerva, as you're running over, your best guess is that a fucking rocket just exploded in front of Dolly?
Oh, Jesus Christ. She ran over the check, what the fuck hit the ground? Like,
yeah, it's a burn mark. You heard that pshu. You heard an explosion. Dolly, basically like a little fire cloud erupted there. Yeah, that's something explosive, whatever it was.
No, Mimi. I always said that I wanted to meet aliens, but...
Minerva, staring at the ground, seeing the explosion, he's gonna panically look across the group. Okay, either you all get some cover, or you spread out from each other. We're dealing with explosives.
Ruth looks at her, and looks at the sky. Something is off, but he doesn't trust that this was simply a simple act of explosive. It was too small to be an explosive.
Okay. Initiative has started. The unknown force is going first.
I'm sorry?
Oh no!
Yeah, it got better than a 13.
Oh no!
Minerva, you hear again. Pew! You look up. There's a rocket headed straight at you.
Shit. She tried, like, fucking... this has to do with the secret action that I just prepped. She has her Haman field out. Can she, like, use that to essentially make a Haman bubble really fast and then, like, make it pop very quickly to send her flying backwards?
Yeah, no problem. Now, this is going to be something that I describe to everybody else but Minerva.
Oh, fun.
Minerva, you did lose that roll. Minerva, actually, let's start with you. You, real quick, Haman bubble shield to dodge away from where you think it's going to be going here. But you look up, beep, beep, in the sky, a red light on that rocket. It turns and it goes towards you anyway.
Shit.
And Dolly, Ruth, and Simba, you watch as basically... this rocket impacts Minerva's chest, and there is a cacophonous explosion as gory bits of Minerva fly all what? Over the playing field.
What?
Bit here, and with a horrifying clunk, head here.
Oh.
Are you shitting me? But that technically sets off a secret action.
Oh, really? Explain.
Essentially, if for any reason communication is broken between Dolly and Minerva, the thing that Dolly passed Minerva was a broken pair of earbuds. Dolly has that as a satellite, and she can send sound through it. They can keep communication even if they're farther away because of that.
Okay. Dolly has that for unknown reasons, other than just simply the fact that you exploded into a bunch of giblets. That secret action does not work.
Shit.
Ruth, it's your turn. You saw Minerva basically just die.
Ruth looks at Minerva's remains. He grabs his mask, covers Dolly's eyes.
Aww.
Simba, you see an aura around Ruth. He's not happy.
Zoa.
Ruth goes towards Simba with Dolly as he let his hair grow out to be a giant dome-like shield around the party. For right now, he's going to set a secret action.
I'm going to give you an opportunity to do something, Dolly, then.
I'm going to throw up.
Yeah, fair. Very fair. If there's anything else you want to do in your turn.
Nope.
Simba?
Everyone, when Ruth looked at Simba, he noticed something that he saw earlier. The menacing aura is back.
Alright, and you guys all bunker down, waiting for something underneath Ruth's giant hair shield. Minerva, it's your turn.
Wait, what?
To everyone else's eyes, you are dead. You exploded into giblets. However, from your perspective, you are hit with that explosive. You see your body basically explode all around you, and while everyone, you see basically everyone has, more or less, like, reconvened over there under the Ruth shield. You see this as, to your perspective...
The fuck? What? Excuse me?
You are a ghost.
So, I'm
You can't
dead?
Actually, like... make noises, but you can think.
Okay. I can see my body, right?
Yeah, you see your head on the ground. It's kinda disgusting.
She has a trait against that, so she's not really bothered. She looks at the group. She just sees her body. She seems a hell of a lot more accepting of death than anything. She's like, well, I guess I died. Well, shit. She's gonna look around at everything going on to see if she can tell where that rocket came from?
Yeah. So, I'm gonna just put this out here. While you are dead, you may not use your stand, and your physical stats of bronze and bravery become one. However, your brain stays at its normal.
Oh, fun.
So, give me a brains check.
Damn it. Is Once Upon December just gone, or like...
You try and summon it forth, you try and do anything with it, it's...
It's kind of in its nature to stay no matter what.
Yeah, it's just not around. Cat!
Maybe
fucking dead.
I want to mention that something Once Upon December would do, this is important, when Minerva got exploded, it would kind of, like, it would slow down, and it would, like, slowly go into the floor. Like, it would look like it's poofing, but it's not. It's in the ground now, just hiding.
That's what it looked like, you're saying?
Yeah, essentially, it faked poofing. It's in the ground, and it's hiding now.
Hell yeah. Minerva, you may be dead, but that doesn't stop your mind from being the perfect calculating machine for the trajectory of that rocket. You follow the arc up, over, back, to your right. and you see... Well, first you see the flash of numbers. Over on the right, on the balcony, if you'll please follow me.
Oh, I fucking knew it!
you're pretty keying in onto it. First, what you see in the darkness is the glint of the letters. M3R-L1N. And then you see it.
Damn it.
A rocket launcher.
Are we fighting a wizard? Oh, Jesus Christ!
Oh.
What is this?
That's what you see! It's got a rocket launcher aimed up into the sky, and it is firing down on the other group.
I gotta ask something.
Yeah.
Did it go through that door?
Technically, yeah.
That set off a secret action.
God damn it, here we go. Alright, what?
When Minerva was up here on the roof, she threw a tiny music box to that door. One of her side abilities for Once Upon a December is that it can imbue music boxes that's wound with a single effect. Minerva has a few that has a few set effects that she has, like, specifically made so that way they don't go off unless they're, like, hit by something. She chucked it over there and it's been by the door, and basically, the requirements is, if someone dramatically appears on the balcony that Minerva stared at her, she will have thrown a small pre-wound music box at the door. That way, when the door opened, it would start playing. The effect inside is extreme unease and nervousness.
That is incredible. KC, I want you to roll 3d6 plus brains for that. That's fucking great. You read me like a book.
I fucking knew it.
Oh my. Alright. As the robot is focusing on firing out these rockets, you notice something. Well, you don't. I guess you would see it from where you're at. So it's incredible unease, yeah?
Yeah, incredible unease and nervousness.
You one by one. It turns its head left, it turns its head right, it tries to figure out where that sound is coming from, and I'm assuming if I get rid of the music box, the effect still stays on it, yeah?
If you get rid of the music box, then it stops, because it only lasts as long as the music is playing.
Okay, well, it localized it, see? And what you see, from your perspective as a ghost, is something dart out behind it incredibly fast, insanely fast. Is that even possible to move that fast? It grabs it, chucks the music box, and it lands down here, but the music box keeps playing. It did not counteract your ability, it just threw it reflexively. So yeah, it's now uneasy.
And it's a robot with a stand. Fun.
Yeah, back to you, Minerva.
I'm curious, can Minerva breathe while a ghost, or is that not the thing?
You cannot breathe while a ghost.
Okay.
You try, your, like, lungs are gone.
I'm guessing that she can possess things, though, because that's the only reason why there'd be so much shit around here.
Alright.
She's going to go over here. How is she able to possess things? I want to try and possess these cards.
You want to try and possess these playing cards?
Yes.
Okay. How do you go about doing that?
She would first, like, try grabbing it, but no hands, and, like, shit, and, like, just try to phase into them, since that's what you'd assume how you'd grab things, I guess, as a ghost, or, like, I guess, like, what Once Upon a December does, where, like, it's not technically limbs, it's just a bunch of, like, ice, but it can touch things.
Yeah.
If it, like, phases into it.
Your little ghost face goes into the cards and... Yeah.
Yay! Cards! Okay, can Minerva move these around as she wishes?
The cards kind of wiggle and, like, flutter around.
Okay.
You do have very slight control of them, yes.
Okay. She's just gonna, like, start dragging them over here, trying to get them, like, to them, to try to communicate, I guess.
Yeah, everyone, you basically see these cards fly over in the wind.
This is such a pain in the ass!
Minerva, your cards. M3R-L1N. Unbeknownst to everybody else, over here, basically there's a sound, a whoosh of steam. Everyone else, you hear a psh! Something happens.
It's gone. Fun.
Would anyone like to make a perception? I'll give one person a perception ability.
Oh, good.
You look around? Okay. Simba, Eagle Eye, you spot it. Flying through the air with some sort of steam-powered shoes? A wizard lands down here.
Oh shit, he got moon shoes.
A robot. Looks like we're facing a robot.
You notice as the... From this distance, it definitely does just look like a wizard. The wizard, with some sort of menacing force behind him, pulls out a wand, a magic wand, and points it at you, Simba.
A magic man.
Simba, through the dome hair, you see... I'm assuming the dome hair protects above, so... What he does is, out the front of that wand, a brilliant red light, and then a zap, as a laser fires at you.
Do I roll durability with Simba's or no?
No, you were protecting above with the dome hair. Simba is exposed.
Rolling durability.
Ruth, Dolly, you're huddling here. Simba, you... What's that? Something touches your foot? As Simba, the laser goes right through your heart and you melt, literally, into a goopy, viscous substance on the floor.
Ah, fun, another ghost.
You lost the roll by 5. You take 5 damage. Since Ooh, everyone knows about the ghost thing...
Wait. Spooky ghosts.
Ruth, Simba just melted behind you. He's on your feet. Ugh.
Can you do anything to restore this?
Explain. What do you want to do specifically?
He gets air pumps for a tire for a bicycle, plugs into the mush. He hopes this works as he starts pumping air.
Okay. So you're basically trying to reinflate the perished Simba corpse that melted.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. You activated a villain section.
God damn it.
The villain section is called "I Find Delight in the Gruesome and Grim." If anyone tries to heal someone who has, air quote, died, either with Haman or other means, suddenly, pew, Ruth, rockets. But you were prepared for this. Your shield is still up.
Oh, good, because that might actually activate a secret action.
Oh, good, eh?
As the missile targets him, he knows this is meant to attack him and make him dead. But in reality, everyone that's alive currently with him has moved high in air, replacing the missile with that of a magic trick. They're in the air going towards the robotic wizard. They swap places.
What? You want to explain a little better? I don't really know what you mean by that.
Like, you know that whole magic box trick where there's like, they swap places, but you can't explain how?
Are you just trying to swap spots with the wizard?
No, the missile in the air.
With the missile in the air? Yourself?
Well, everyone that's in my range.
So
let's roll secret actions for starters. This was to... I'll determine what happens depending on who wins. What was the trigger for this? Can you explain it?
If Ruth ever gets shot by a missile.
Okay, yeah. No, it's very basic. It is basically you get attacked. So I will give you 1d6 plus brains for that. Please roll that. Escalation.
Oh, God.
You win. Alright, Ruth, you swap places with that rocket. Suddenly, Ruth is in the air. It looks like, Dolly, an explosion on the ground next to you, knocking you back. Dolly is going to take splash damage from this, but Ruth, you are in the sky, so Dolly...
No, you're forgetting. Everyone that's a...
Ruth took everyone near him with him.
Yeah.
I think it's a little bullshit to say literally everyone is up there. I'm going to just move Ruth. Yeah, so Dolly, a rocket explodes at your feet. Is there anything you want to do to stop that?
I'll be honest, she's not doing anything right now.
Nothing?
Nope.
Uh-oh. I think she's having a hell of a breakdown.
Dolly!
There is one thing that'll happen. And that's it.
And you, is that a pillar of hats?
All the hats.
It's even better, it's a hug pile of hats.
Oh, God! The Sunday clothes. Take the hit. You take no damage.
Or a little interesting, he's high in the air to see the Stan and the user, right?
Yes, you are.
He points to the wizard for Dolly to see.
She's not seeing anything.
I think Dolly's in her hug pile right now. She's coping.
You actually hear something from this. Not from the wizard, but oddly enough from behind you as you're falling. This speaker right here. You hear,
"Halt, intruders. I'm the great wizard, Merlin."
And you fall back down.
Ah, jeez.
Dolly!
You think?
Oh, baby!
Dolly, please.
Dolly!
So all the Sunday clothes units, they're gonna summon around Dolly. Just one big pile, and across the entirety of her range, it is completely dead silent.
Oh, you want to have absorbed the explosion?
Yeah.
Okay.
Does she see the cards fluttering? Is Minerva's trying?
Up to you.
I'll roll a dice.
Okay.
See, she's too sad. Please.
It's a one.
Aww.
Baby, see nothing, no.
Fuck.
Let me see. I'll also give you another point from just absorbing basically the sound of the speaker. You have a feeling that the wizard is cussing you out, but you can't hear anything. Simba, suddenly you melted. What's that? An explosion? Ruth in the sky? Dolly is crying? There's some cards and... No, that's not right. You don't look like that normally.
It blows the menacing field. More menace.
Oh, he going?
He going. Wait, if we... Can we... No! Oh my god.
Where are you going, Simba?
What is Simba doing?
I don't know. What are you doing?
Somehow they feel menaced. From beyond the grave!
Simba went all the way up here, is just staring at him.
Merlin turns and looks at you.
Oh, and what do you think you're gonna do, you little shit?
I'm gonna show you why technology isn't superior. Yeah, he goes into the piano.
Hell yeah! Piano possession! Okay, give me a second to give you control over the fucking piano.
Fortunately for Marilyn, Simba knows how to play the piano.
Is he just gonna harass him with piano noises?
Menacing fucking piano.
The menacing piano.
Yeah, piano begins to play a song. It sounds weird. It almost makes you kind of depressed. It's the Hungarian suicide song.
Oh my god.
You're gonna throw off the wizard's groove, man. Like, what?
He threw off his groove! is there anything you want to do with that, or are you just being menacing?
Menacing.
Okay, fair enough. I'm gonna move on to Minerva cards.
Yay! Minerva, I'm assuming she's able to get him over here now. She's
yeah.
Like, god damn it! Totally, no, it's not the time to be depressed, Jesus. She's gonna at first try, like, push Dolly. I'm guessing she's not able to because ghost.
The cards can definitely, like, tap against Dolly's face or something, like, flutter around her.
I'm gonna have one smack of instance of Sunday clothes on the face.
The cards are cards. They go through Sunday clothes.
Shit! Just gonna harass her. Just smack Dolly in the face with the card. She's gonna smack her in the face with the Queen of Hearts card that I'm guessing she has.
Oh. Yeah, of course.
Slapping her over and over again. God damn it, stop being depressed!
Oh, I also forgot to mention this. When you possess objects, your base physical stats go up. Minerva, your cards right now, so they stay at 1. Simba, your physical stats as a piano. You chose a fucking piano, you're chonky. You got a bronze of 6, but you got a bravery of like 3 because stage fright.
Chonky.
Chonky piano. Minerva, actually, your bravery goes way up because people bluff all the time with cards. So you got 5 bravery with the cards.
Fuck Dolly! Can I, like, is Dolly, like, gonna actually pay attention to the fucking cards or just gonna smack them?
She, at this point, I think she'd start like, not calming down, you know. I think she'll notice them.
Okay. I'm gonna do a thing. Minerva taking the, I'm guessing she has a lot more cards than in the thing, or does she only have a few? I gotta
It's a full deck.
Okay, cool, she has a lot of cards. Minerva is going to start, the cards are going to start ordering themselves in a sequence of red and black. Essentially, what Minerva's doing is that she's placing them in Morse code, like, in a line, and, like, when she, like, gets a bit far, she, like, picks up the ones that she put down first, and she puts them to the end, and, like, she's essentially typing out the message, "Not dead, stop crying."
Alright. Minerva starts to spell out these. I'm not dead. It gets to I'm not dead. Dolly, you see? You activated a villainous action, Minerva.
Ah, dick!
Black sorcery is my dish of tea. If someone tries to spell out words, well, a ghost.
God damn it.
Basically, the card pile gets shot by a laser beam. That laser beam, it wasn't from Merlin.
What?
You get shot. Dolly, Ruth, the laser beam. One of the cameras.
What? Oh no!
I'm gonna message Kat something real quick.
Kat!
yeah. Basically, the laser came from that. So, Minerva, can you roll me Bronze of Cards, which is a d6 plus 1? And I'm gonna roll something in secret. This one has a name tag on it.
Well, fuck!
Oh, damn, you rolled a 1? Okay. Some of the cards are burned. You take 3 damage, Minerva.
Ow!
But I'm not dead is still spelled out.
Dolly, you better fucking get this because that hurt like a bitch! Can I stop possessing something?
Yes, you can. Do you want to try and stop possessing the cards?
Yes, she's gonna stop possessing these cards.
Okay, the cards flutter as they're shot.
I'm not dead.
I'm not dead. I'm not dead. What?
Okay. Minerva popped out of the thing. It's just like cursing internally. Just got to put her like a bitch. Dolly, you better fucking get this. I hate being dead. Since technically I rolled against him, can I do a monologue?
Yes, you can!
Hurrah! That reminded me. Minerva internally, just after cursing everything from being shot by cards, and just like, God damn it. It seems that whenever we're attacked by one of its attacks, either just anything from what I've seen so far, it makes us seem dead. Maybe we're actually dead, but it doesn't matter. It essentially destroys our bodies and leaves our spirits around to be here. I doubt that we are dead, though. It would not make sense. There must be something weird about this.
Alright. I got the gist. I'm going to say you are partially correct. and I'm going to drop it by one.
Hurrah!
Merlin. Clonk, clonk. Steam spews from Merlin's boots as he leans over the edge and looks down at you, Simba, the piano.
And what's been the most depressing song in the known to music?
Menacing the ragtime.
Hiding won't save ya, bitch.
There's a burst of steam as Merlin vanishes from your perceptions and then falls back down out of the sky, stomping on the piano.
Did he grand slam the fucking piano?
He might have just fucking ground pounded the piano with rocket boots.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so you are a piano, so your bronze is 6. Can I get a bronze roll? Escalation.
Okay.
So Merlin lands on the piano with a heavy clunk, and the center of the wood cracks heavily. Simba, you take 6 damage as a few of the keys fly out. The wizard just kind of rubs in his boot.
How's that feel, you criminal scum?
I don't even know how I got here! Only he could hear that.
Yeah, the stand at blinding speed flies over here.
Ah, fuck!
And it grabs Minerva's ghost. The other two of you, you just see a stand grabbing nothing. Minerva, there's no way you could physically beat this roll.
Shit.
This is a perfect opportunity for topsy-turvy day. He poses as he grabs something that looks like it's nothing at all. He swings like he's having trouble. He's hitting her with the mine car.
He pulled out the car and he bonked the stand on the head with it.
Bonking the stand on the head with a car? Hold on, let me grab your car.
An invisible car.
Bonk.
I swear to God, it bonked Minerva too.
Yeah, that would happen, unfortunately.
Fuck! What's my bronze as ghost?
It is 1, unfortunately. Give me that attack roll, Ruth.
No,
fuck.
A d6 plus 1.
Yeah. Oh, damn, you take 1 damage, Minerva.
Yay!
And then, the stand actually, quicker than you think possible, it grabs Minerva. Or, sorry, you don't see it grab Minerva. It grabs you, Minerva, and it flips back up. And it flips almost over here, almost like it's teleporting? It's not teleporting, though, it's just moving that damn fast.
We've thought about it or something for a moment. Monologue action.
Hell yeah.
Points at the stand as he thinks. That thing, is it possible? It's wired to the network of security cameras or electrical equipment? Maybe it can see something that's out of our range of sight, but not for the stand user or the stand.
Ooh, very smart. I like that. This will give you some information. Ruth, you're actually wrong.
Alright. Can Ruth move towards the stand in a same fast speed?
You've already used your stand, but you can definitely just, like, hustle run up.
Yep. He does the fisticuffs at the stand. Like, bring it on.
A voice comes through the speakers.
Oh, put a sock in it, you stupid clown!
He puts it aside. I'm a
boy. Your piano playing in the background.
Yeah, there's a piano too. Actually, Dolly, are you absorbing the speakers right now?
Yes.
Yeah, no, the wizard, Ruth, you get the sense that the wizard's pissed at you.
So do I see that stand?
You do.
Have I seen that wizard?
You have seen that wizard.
Right. I'd like to make a monologue action.
This would have to be unopposed, and you'd have to get the power perfectly right.
My monologue is that stand's about to die right now.
Wait.
Oh. I see.
Please do not murder the Minerva. Minerva does not need
Fucking Christ. Oh, so menacing, dude.
Can my sound attack stands?
Yes.
Good. If I spend a plot point, can I have it go over Minerva?
Through some sort of bullshit means with a plot point, I'm okay with that.
So sound is a wave.
Hmm.
Now, it is a longitudinal wave, but so you can suddenly close, it steals sounds and it magnifies them. So surely if it's magnifying it, it will just simply magnify the shape of the curve so that it bends around Minerva and it hits the stand in the head.
That was fucking brilliant. I am so okay with that.
Wait, please. I'm spending all of them. 6 plus 5d6, keep 4.
You're using 8 points, correct?
Yeah.
Dolly, the sound wave bends perfectly underneath Minerva, knocking into the stand's head, and the vibrations themselves frazzle the hair in such a way that the stand more or less dissolves. I'm unsummoning it. You dealt 14 damage. I'm spending a bizarre field point to negate 10 of that, so it only takes 4. And it unsummons, but you took down the bizarre field by 1.
Oh, Jesus.
A chunky stand, user.
Yay, I'm free!
All I was doing all that, the panel's playing Sunday Cloves. Simba immediately gets out of the piano.
You're leaving the piano?
Right. Yeah, I'm leaving the piano.
You pop back out. The ghost flies out of the piano. The wizard, its eyes are tracking you. It can see you.
Can I actually ask him? Is the wizard inside the bumper cart section?
Technically this piano's on the outside and he's on top of it, so he's like on the fringe of it.
Okay, I have to say that the piano moved slightly backwards when
you want to plot point it?
Yes, plot point, the piano moved backwards a wee bit, making Merlin fall into the other side there.
Okay, that is acceptable.
Okay, then I'm gonna head towards one of the bumper carts.
Hell yeah!
Aggressive bumper car ghosts!
But I'm gonna have to roll something. Because of the flaw!
Oh yeah!
Fuck!
Distrust of technology.
Ah, oof. Fuck!
Yeah, Simba. You don't trust that fucking bumper car, not one bit.
Nah, that's not. I'm just gonna head to the trombone.
The trombone.
Where's the trombone? Oh,
the trumpet. Yeah.
You gonna aggressively dude at him?
Aggressively dude at him.
Yeah.
Oh, goddammit, we're not getting trumpet Jesus in here.
We might be getting trumpet Jesus in here. Simba, do you possess the trumpet?
Yes.
All right, trumpet Jesus time.
Oh, goddammit.
Oh, he's just gonna aggressively dude at him.
Minerva Ghost.
Oh, god damn it.
You're free.
Yay! Grace, Dolly. can I do that?
I mean, you get the feeling that you might be able to.
Hell yeah! The Dolly. Minerva's possessing Dolly's legs.
Minerva, choose a leg, left or right.
God, right leg.
Okay, Dolly's right leg is now Minerva.
Hell yeah, gun comes out, ready to fucking go. The gun comes out, like, taps a bit against the leg to, like, make a bit of noise. Just...
God...
Damn it, Dolly! I was gonna, like, flip around. She's just staring at this thing.
Ah, yes. It seems to have its eye targeted on all of you. It's a camera with, like, a snake-like limb behind it.
Okay, then. She's just like, how the fuck do I use a shotgun? She's gonna try the fire at that thing, but she's bad at shotguns. She hasn't used a gun before.
Dolly, your leg raises and aims at the fucking camera. Do you try and stop it from shooting the camera?
No.
No? Okay. Yeah, a shotgun shell goes right through the eye of this camera robot. It takes 6 damage.
Hell yeah.
And a few sparks fly up.
Since that was happening, I wanted to monologue. So, we're fighting against that thing and it lasered, but there's 2 stands on this field. No, not 2 stands, 1 stand. But one of them's attacking and the other one is making the effects. It seems that whoever that is with the red eye is controlling the weapons that are causing our deaths.
Ooh. You are incorrect.
Thick.
So all of you see as on the bumper cart track, clunk, 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 this robot starts to approach you. It seems to be ignoring the trumpet.
The trumpet is tooting unicorn wizard by Ninja Sex Party.
As it gets here, it hops up on the fence, and it looks down at you, Dolly and Ruth.
If you're gonna keep resisting, I'm gonna have to kill all of y'all.
You already have.
Dolly! It levels its arm at you, and you see underneath the cloak a rocket launcher, and a rocket flies at you.
If I try and jump away with my robot legs, does that count as cybernetic weapons or not?
I think that would count as cybernetic weapons, yes.
Does the rocket have the red light like it did before when Minerva got attacked?
It does.
Can Minerva take the shotgun and try to aim it specifically at that light and try to shoot it out of the air?
Yeah. Curly, I'm gonna give you a +3 onto this roll, because Casey is onto something. Dolly jumps to the side, and a rocket hits the ground here.
Woo!
However, part of the shrapnel from the explosion, Minerva, you disabled the homing technology. Dolly, you land, but you look down on your hand. Just the smallest cut on your pinky finger. You take 4 damage, and Minerva, you are suddenly thrust outwards as Dolly explodes into confetti.
Shit! Dolly, no!
And if you'll give me a second, Dolly, Minerva, you see each other.
Dolly!
Can ghosts cry?
Oh! I mean, yeah,
baby!
Dude!
Baby!
Yeah, you can cry.
Ah! Poor Dolly baby.
And with that, the last man standing. Everything just silent. Tears running down his cheek. He is not one bit happy, angrily staring at Merlin. Topsy-turvy day. Its power is quite a bit, but with no one around to actually hurt anyone, Ruth doesn't care about himself anymore. He has to go all out for the sake of his friends and to stop this maniacal robot. Ruth turns himself into the world's biggest pinball and shots at an incredible speed towards Merlin.
Okay. So, Ruth turns into a pinball in a moment of pure rage. Merlin starts to turn towards you after having defeated, air quote, killed Dolly as she popped into confetti. He tilts his head as the pinball comes in.
Just one left.
And Merlin aims his wand at your pinball, in which you see a red light starting to form. Merlin is going to counter with his own attack as he fires a laser at the pinball. At this moment, shing! You donk him on the head, he falls down onto the ground, and the laser glances off your pinball. As you land over here, neither of you actually took any damage. Because you're a wearable stand, and he beat you by only one.
Ruth stands up. Menace. It just keeps growing. He looks at Merlin. He doesn't speak. He stares out of pure, unimaginable hatred. Ruth, for the first time in ever, he doesn't know how to speak in a long time. He doesn't remove the mask. All he reveals was a sign. Topsy-turvy day.
The wizard arcs a finger at you.
Cute parlor tricks, kid.
Can I spend a resolve to attack again?
Yeah.
Yeah? As he says cute parlor trick, Ruth is in his face with a giant boxing glove.
The wizard, having not prepared for this, is going to try and backpedal away from you. I'm going to get rid of a little bit of this menace. He is going to basically start blocking your boxing glove attacks, your flurry of enraged blows, as he brings one of his feet up and kicks back with a burst of steam.
Question, can I?
Escalation. Escalation. Oh. Oh, fuck!
Hey, tell me!
All throughout the battlefield, there's a resounding ding ding of a bell as Ruth lands an uppercut underneath the wizard's jaw, and he goes flying backwards and slams into this bumper car right here. The wizard takes 12 damage.
Hell yeah!
He cracks his knuckles, standing there with that boxing glove.
I see. So you are also a user of Kung Fu.
He puts his fists
up. God damn it!
He prepares to come back at you with more karate moves. Dolly Ghost. That was fucking incredible!
That was so cool!
Yeah, Dolly, you're a ghost. You're crying. Back to this. Uh-huh. Jesus fucking Christ.
Baby.
Aww. Dolly, when you touch Minerva, when you collide, you feel a psychic link. As long as you two are touching, you may talk to each other.
Dolly! Dolly, stop. I'm not... Well, I looked dead. Maybe we're dead. We're not dead.
That's
we're not
hoping.
Dead right now. Oh, damn it. Where the fuck is... Whatever. Dolly, please stop crying. Well, at least... what the fuck is the raccoon doing?
The raccoon is crawling into the French horn.
Okay. Dolly, please, we're in the middle of a fight! Wait, did Dolly's entire body go up in confetti, or are her legs still around?
Her whole body.
Oh, god damn it! Well, looks like we can't take the legs. Do you want to take the knife?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take the spoon then. I just realized that everyone here has had menacing moments and Minerva's just been tired.
Simba's a tuba.
I want to do loads of things with this knife. Can I do a combo move?
I mean, yeah. Explain it to me.
You ever heard of a catapult?
Yes.
You ever heard of a spoon?
No.
What if?
No.
We combine two good things.
The knife going flying.
I'm going right into that wizard's eye.
Oh, hell yeah. Minerva, as she's about to, like, fucking chuck Dolly, she's like, go fuck him up for killing me. Motherfucker didn't even let me speak. Yeet!
Chunk. Dolly, you land the knife in the wizard's fucking eyeball, and you hear a...
Oh, son of a fucking bitch!
The wizard takes 4 damage. And Dolly, you're stuck in the wizard. You two can communicate if you wish, because of the psychic link.
Dolly's not going to say a single word to him. Can I monologue?
Yeah, of course.
My monologue is that this stand, when it hits you with any form of damage, fatal or otherwise, its ability will activate, and it will cause your physical body to appear here to break apart, whilst your ghost, without a stand, lives on. Well, not lives, but no.
You are correct.
Yeah. Elliot!
It's only got 1 bizarre field point left. This little camera unhooks and starts slithering around the top of the roof. It's going to slither off in this direction, but before it goes, it stands up real straight, almost like a... like how a meerkat would stand in the desert. Super straight up. And then it angles its camera body part down towards you, Ruth. A red beam of light glows there, and... yeah, Ruth, you're getting shot by a laser beam.
So I don't see this coming, do I?
Not really. I mean, you can theoretically see it, but you're pretty hard set on fucking Merlin.
Can Ruth's topsy-turvy just act without him knowing, just making a invisible wall?
Oh, yeah, Ruth, your instincts kick in and an invisible wall appears. However, something still hits your hat. You take 5 damage as a laser singes your forehead. -2 because wearable stand.
So does this mean I go exploding like the rest, or what?
No, your hat's just singed.
I'm just gonna get out of the trumpet now.
You're just gonna get out of the trumpet? Alright, fair enough.
So, I was gonna check them. There's a door here. In here.
There is.
Goes in the door. Goes through the door.
Okay, you get to a... basically a, like, top room, staircase leading down. I don't really know what would be up here.
Dry goods for the concession stand.
Bumper car grease, too.
Sure.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay, so we're just gonna meet, like, go back. Damn, no, isn't there. Question, can I consolidate Hype Man things still?
You can, but you would have to be currently possessing something for them to work, because your ghost form, you can't really hype people up if they don't know you're there.
Okay, be able to get to what this football, I mean, this American football.
Yeah, I think you're able to get that far.
Ball!
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 No, wait. I feel like something.
Huh?
Trumpet.
Oh my god.
Oh!
The trumpet with
the horn with the raccoon in it?
Yeah.
Aw.
Ah, the French horn?
Yes, I approve. I approve.
Is this a French horn?
So I can now talk to the raccoon, because we're connected.
Yeah, you can now use your stand also, because you possessed this, so you can talk to the raccoon.
Hello there. I do not have not let go of the trumpet of this thing. Let's insert the name of what this thing is. Did you see the thing, the laser type shooty thing earlier?
Blood sound guy?
What?
Loud sound guy. He shoots low. Go back, boom.
No.
Huh?
No, not him. Then it looks like one of those cameras.
Don't. Oh, that's what you mean.
Uh-huh.
I have no idea what you mean.
Okay.
I love this raccoon. How long has this raccoon been in the horn?
Oh, that sturdy crawled over here.
Question. If Simba can Simba basically make the raccoon feel where it's where he means?
Brains roll to raccoon, I guess. Oh, it starts climbing.
Yeah, I know that snake. Funny tube snake.
It leaves.
Attack it!
The raccoon.
Not Jordan.
Jordan.
I'm gonna call it a hype man action now.
Okay, you said a hype man as coon. Kat, do you want Jordan to do anything as a raccoon is fucking bouncing
at? Can I create a feedback loop?
Ooh. Simba horn, Minerva spoon, and actually no, fuck it, all of you would hear as an excruciatingly shrill feedback sound emits from over here. The raccoon takes one look at that thing and it fucking bolts.
Understandable.
Yeah, you horrified the raccoon.
Poor mafia trash panda.
This raccoon asset, can I just say, gives me the vibe of rats.
Rats.
We're the rats. It has that shape.
We're the raccoon.
Okay, Minerva spoon.
Rack.
Oh, fun.
Minerva's a spoon?
Minerva's a spoon.
Oh, the giant wooden spoon?
She's not a spoon anymore because she's popping out that... I want to test something. This is gonna sound really crazy. Can Minerva possess the park?
Did we ever set a size limit? I don't think we set a size limit.
Okay, I think it's unlikely that Minerva would be able to handle the sheer amount of park.
Why don't we do it that way, actually? Minerva, you go down into the ground, you feel your consciousness spread out, but it stops on the edge of... If you rack your brain, oh, where that cage was you saw. You have possessed the entirety of Wizardtopia!
I did not think that would work!
Now hold on. Roll brains as you take fucking psychic damage from the strain! Escalation!
No!
Oh shit!
Oh no!
Oh no!
What happens?
You take 6 damage as you are shunted back out of the universe. Fucking splitting migraine!
Fuck! Well, it was a good thing to try. Can I do anything else? Because... I want to do something else.
You can do something else, but man, does your head hurt. You tried to possess the fucking planet.
Hack the planet.
I want to try to possess something else. I'm probably going to die from this. So,
oh god.
Yay. I want to try to possess Jordan. He is a camera.
You want to possess Jordan?
Yes!
Oh no, Jordan! Jeez, you are just gonna fucking, like, fight everything this game. Oh my god, alright.
Come at me, fucker!
Come on, Minerva, you hear twitting, and then there's a song.
Are you hiding her?
You don't know how Simba would know, but it's somehow one of your... a song from one of your favorite bands, from one of your favorite music groups.
What?
It's Money.
God damn it. Damn it!
What the fuck?
Fuck. Does that mean, like, if we it doesn't matter if we have resolve or not, if we hit zero, we're fucking gone?
If you run out of resolve and you hit zero, you will die.
Okay, I'm not getting rid of this last resolve then.
Pillage.
Okay, yeah, you donk, Jordan. You get the feeling that almost worked.
Damn it. I rolled so bad!
21s! The fuck? Alright, back to Merlin.
Merlin.
Merlin pulls Dolly out of his fucking eye. Looks down at Dolly.
You little pest, get the hell out of here.
And Merlin is going to hand Dolly back to his stand, who is going to grab Dolly and fucking huck her as far as it can. Hucks Dolly knife at Ruth.
This pure calm as he lets the stand effect comes into play. As it got really close, Ruth will use his own speed to bring the knife to a bumper car.
I'm sorry? What are you doing?
I'm redirecting that knife to a bumper car behind him.
Can you explain a little better than redirecting?
He's dodging, like ducking out of the way.
Literally just ducking out of the way and having it hit the bumper car behind you?
Yep.
That works perfectly. That would be a bronze roll.
Bronze? I would think it would be speed. Because
you are not using your stand to do that. You're just ducking. Bronze.
You're just ducking.
Can I say he shrinks into the ground like puddle of water?
I don't appreciate that you're trying to get the stand stat anyway, but I'll allow it this turn. Yes, you may.
Sorry. That's better.
Two more.
That doesn't hate.
Yeah. Ruth, you melt. But that knife, it was already stuck in you. And Ruth, as you take this damage, the knife, it, as you melt around, this is a fun way to describe it. Yeah, it's sticking out of, like, a cartoonish red beating heart in the center of the puddle, which boom, 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 and slows down and stops. Ruth, you got ghosted. Dolly, you are currently, actually, technically, you two have psychic connection right now. Because you are stabbing into Ruth's ghost.
Dolly, can you hear me?
Sorry.
Oh god, this is gonna be weird. First time ever, don't tell anyone about my... this.
When I stab you, you'll be alright.
Listen, there's two bumper cars near him. We can use him.
Speaking of bumper cars, as you say this, you notice, clunk clunk, Merlin. He's gotten into a bumper car.
Oh, that is a poor idea because, Ruth had that smile still.
Hey, Ruth.
Ah, this is terrible. Why do I... I don't mind thinking inside my head, but this is a little awkward.
Are you British?
No, I'm oftentimes not sure what my accent to go for. I have been talking for so long, I don't know what I originally sound like anymore.
I ain't gonna question it.
Hey, Ruth, the antagonist is spending a resolve to take another action. While you're talking, Dolly knife in Ruth, the bumper car fucking tries to run over the knife.
Ah, good, because that's what I wanted.
Is it? Dolly, this is an attack at you.
Can I have the knife? Can I try and use the knife to break itself off? And I fall into one of the metal blades, which falls on its side and goes right underneath it.
Yeah. Dolly, Ruth, there is a crunching sound as the bumper car runs over the knife. Dolly, you take 3 damage.
Okay.
Oh no, not 20 health.
I'll grind you into the ground for disrespecting our company.
But we didn't do anything.
We just existed, man!
And as he says that, car possession.
Flip that car!
Okay, cars are a +4 in all stats.
Oh, hell yeah.
I'm gonna do something far worse than flip a car.
Oh, goddamn.
So, he's driving it, thinking he's still won. Stops.
You just have him fly out of it?
No. Far worse. Seatbelt click, as radio plays through the car, the bumper car, French song, as Ruth's gonna have this Merlin go for a ride with the bumper cars going at top speeds, bumping in, out, all around this, inside this cage, doing as much as possible damage Make him sick. Make him unconcentrated.
Okay, that's a little bit too much for one action, so I will offer you the idea. Do you want to drive the car somewhere to try and damage him, or do you want to restrain him by trying to strap him in with the seatbelts first?
Let's do with the damage, because he's not expecting this.
Okay, sounds good. Basically, you ride him around, you slam on him, you suddenly slam on the brakes, and his head just slams into the steering wheel. Takes 2 damage, and he says,
"You foolish clown! I'm nigh indestructible!"
Brick's sake, the doubts.
I'm setting a secret action.
Oh god. Dolly knife.
Alright, so first of all, I'm gonna get out of that knife.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, he hit his head in the steering wheel.
Yeah.
Alright, so I'm gonna go, and I'm gonna possess bump car's electronics.
I think because Ruth is already possessing that, you actually can't.
Oh, no, I just have to possess another one then.
That works.
Yeah, so I'm just running him over. I'm smashing right into that window.
Oh, perfect. Okay. Nice. Merlin is going to point his wand at you, shoot a laser beam, and shoot out the tires, which he does so successfully. You just kind of roll slowly forward and donk his car on the nose, but you feel the sensation of the car taking the 4 damage.
I've got a theory, and I'm not sure it's right. So this stand ability is an area of effect where it can only affect us if we're within the space within the cage.
You are incorrect.
Dick.
Through the cage. Can I overload this car's engine?
For what purpose?
I'm setting it on fire.
I'm okay with that. It won't do anything immediately, but the car does set on fire.
I want to get the fuck out of the car, then.
And it is Jordan's turn. Kat, do you want to play Jordan?
I can play Jordan. Jordan's pretty safe right now. Well, actually, no, there's a Minerva.
There's a Minerva right there.
The bad Jordan can't see the Minerva.
Can I see the Minerva?
You actually can't.
What? Oh.
Okay. But something... I felt that Jordan felt something try to, like...
Do something, yeah.
Jordan's gonna go down.
Fucking let me grab!
There we go. Jordan's gonna go down here.
Damn, he's speedy!
There we go! He slithered.
Oh, he actually pushed over to you.
I wanna possess the thing!
Yeah, Jordan's, that's all Jordan's gonna do.
Jordan's gonna run from the ghost!
Fair enough. Simba!
Of course, no longer this hype man, but out of the trumpet, I'm realizing something. He's not afraid of technology when it comes to music. So, Simba looks at
the speaker
and goes into it. Plans to play a song loud and clear.
You're going into the speakers, yes?
Yes.
Simba, you activated a villainous action.
Hooray!
What did he do?
He got a thing.
He's changing the music on the speakers, which is, in a way, disabling with the speaker's effects. Silvery voice, purple hair. If someone tries to call out for help, disable the speakers, change the speaker's effect, or otherwise leave the playing field. Simba.
Mm-hmm.
Simba. You notice about this robot, 1, it is flying, 2, it has a knife, and a gun.
Yeah, and basically my thought was that it cuts the wires on that speaker.
Yep. Slicey slice.
You take 1 damage.
He's out!
And he's out. If everyone could scroll down to Merlin, please, in this. Merlin, whose face keeps getting repeatedly slammed into the steering wheel over and over again by the ghosts possessing them. Merlin starts to say, starts to speak through the speakers.
You absolute fools. First, you invade our park. Second, you conspire to take down Misney. And third, you harm the rightfully appointed defendant of the Corporation of Misney. My stand allows me to, if I even graze you with one of my attacks, cause you to comically explode, perish, or otherwise die, turning you into a ghost that only I can see. It's wonderful, isn't it?
As the stand comes down and strokes underneath his chin.
That is the power of my stand, Mad Madam Mim.
Oh, par. Should have known it was that from there.
It looks so good! Oh, shit, it's fast!
It's got an A+speed, yeah.
But wow, is Merlin really cool looking. It's so great. I know he's trying to murder us, but I gotta compliment when someone looks good. Like, goddamn.
He's got that style, dude.
He's got style to him.
Now that that's over, Minerva Ghost.
Oh, fun, I'm running after the snake thing. Fuck you, I'm getting that camera.
Do not fuck with my bebe.
Give me the camera!
Give me the camera! we're doing this again.
Nope. Okay. Time to see more ones, fuck yeah. So a d6?
D1.
Yay, possess the boy!
The boy.
Minerva!
What?
As you possess this camera, you hear something. You hear, oh, hello there.
Hi.
What do you think you're doing?
I don't, trying not to die, I guess.
I mean, you could have just given up. Merlin is very, very forgiving. Oh, he will pick your hand.
Yeah, right.
He literally made me explode instantly.
Yes, like, he does that to everyone. I'm surprised he hasn't done the anvil one yet. Well, what are you doing in the park? You have a red ticket, don't you?
I was just here as a guest. I don't know why I have a ticket like that. I thought it was a prince.
You know
again.
Who gave it to you?
I was telling
her that. I told her it was a printing error, but we seem to think otherwise. I'm just wondering if you know where you got it. Did you get it by mail? Did you get it from somebody? Did somebody give it to you?
Did Minerva get her ticket?
Mail.
Oh, I got it from mail. It was just a thing that was sent to my house. I went to the park because vacation. I thought, why not? And then everything started exploding.
I see. That is a fair assumption. Which one are you again?
You mean ghost? My name is...
Yeah, I know you are ghost, but I cannot tell which one is which.
I can understand that. My name is Minerva.
Ah, MiMi!
What?
Oh, God,
I've heard a lot about you.
We're going! Cats unlocks their true potential, fuck!
If I may suggest one thing to you.
What?
Get out of the camera.
God damn it!
Merlin, getting sandwiched between these two, his stand, Madam Mim. She grabs him around the waist, and he plants both of his feet down, and you hear psh as he launches himself straight upwards, 90 feet into the air, with his rocket shoes. As he's flying up into the air, Madam Mim, using its incredible speed, will throw him slightly higher up, allowing him to get an aerial view as he launches a rocket down on both of these cars. Now I get to roll this for you guys.
So that's 1d6 plus 4.
Plus 4 for both of you, yes. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And also, I'm going to resolve rush.
You're going to resolve rush it?
I'm only at 4.
Ruth, part of the car explodes. You take 2 damage. Simple enough. Dolly succeeds with the resolve rush. Dolly, what exactly are you trying to have happen?
I'm going to try and just drive. So there's an explosion, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm on fire.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to try and drive forward in a way that make the explosion launch me up backward. Yeah.
You want to ride the explosion and fly up to meet him?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Merlin, as the smoke is clearing, suddenly an explosion.
What?
And he gets beamed, taking 2 damage from your fucking reversal car. Dolly and Merlin are now locked in a Joestar Manor-esque falling forever type JoJo scenario. You guys, he's on standing on the hood of your car that's on fire. That's his turn, Ruth.
I'm going to switch to another car. He has to position this just right. These things don't have wheels, and he can't use his stand, can he?
While he's possessing it, he can attempt to use his stand. Yes.
He's going to use topsy-turvy day on the blue car. As he possesses it, ready to do probably something ridiculous. He's going to meet halfway with Dolly. He's going to jump and collide with Dolly. Beep, beep.
All right, so the mechanical wheels underneath this car spring outwards, launching the blue car up. As Dolly's flying, a blue car slowly raises beneath the on-fire green car to meet Merlin. These cars are now side by side. Merlin could hop between them. I see a resounding ghost scream for sandwich him.
Yeah, we're basically sandwiching him because a giant rocket-propelled jet-fueled just comes out of the back of the bumper, hoping to hit him before he leaves.
Okay, him on top of one flaming car. You come down from above him somehow through some stroke of genius. Roll the d6 plus 4. Merlin... okay, what Merlin's gonna do is Madam Mim is going to shove him off the side of the burning car with speed. Merlin is above rank 1 cyborg. He's gonna add a d6 on top of that. He takes 5 damage as he launches himself out of the car sandwich. No, he would have lost by 1 with that roll. And he turns, faces back towards everyone.
And you ghosts! You're really something else! Let's see what happens when you blow this place sky high.
You two start falling. Dolly, Ruth is on top of you. You two have telekinetic conversation.
We can try and use our stand as ghost, right?
You can, yes. Also, Dolly, you take, you take 2 damage from being literally on fire.
Can I try it? Hi, and when the cars smash together, can I try and summon Sunday Clothes to capture the noise and then blast the cars back at Merlin?
Yes. Bronze for him to take a car in the pecs. Damn. He takes a burning car on the pecs.
A secondary action to get out.
What's with this pansy shit?
Yes, you can get out.
I'm running away.
You going over this way?
Are you gonna miss the piano?
Is it piano time?
Hiding behind it.
Okay.
Unless Minerva's gonna leave the camera, the inspector's gonna keep talking.
Can I at least ask for your name before you, try to attack me or something? I don't know what's happening.
I cannot attack you mostly because I'm very tired. I'm just watching. You can call me Spectre.
Okay. Everything is happening and I'm dead.
You won't be dead for long. It looks like Merlin's going to go down. I guess I will have to update the X9 series.
Okay, it's nice to know that the person who is trying to murder us is talking to me right now.
I'm not trying to murder you. He's just set on patrols, and if we detect stand users, that seems to technically always be a problem.
We were just here playing bumper cars!
Yes, well, Cloud9 also thinks that you're a problem because you have red tickets, so... I listen to her because I have to, not because I want to.
I swear to God, I'm going to burn that ticket when I get my body back, if I get my body back.
I mean, you could give it to me.
I don't give a shit about tickets!
I would like to inspect it if you would not mind.
Simba does not have a ticket.
Pepper actually gave you one last episode.
Yeah, but it's not red.
You're right, it's not red.
Christ, fuck, I did not expect this period of time in my life to be this crazy. I thought it would be nicer.
I mean, you're a Zeppeli, aren't you?
Yes.
Shit comes your way no matter what.
I fucking know that!
It's only good to get worse.
It's only good to get worse.
Fuck.
I mean, if you're going to stay in the camera, could you at least get a little closer? Jordan's what? Gotten beat up a little bit, so the camera quality isn't very good. If you could get closer, that would be great.
Fuck, I can't really do anything else with this, so sure. Just gotta move closer to the battle, then!
Oh, thank you.
I guess we're going up here.
Hell yeah.
Better view of whatever the fuck's happening. Minerva's just trying to cope with what's happening.
Hey, Spectre, since it's been revealed that you're doing things, you wanna tell me what you're doing with Sarah?
With Sarah? Oh, hell yeah. Who's the most threatened? Well, actually, I can only see Merlin. Well, I can see this car.
Yeah, the Ruth car?
Yeah, can I shoot it?
Yeah.
Gun.
What does this count? Durability or speed?
Car.
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 Car bronze. Car bronze.
Can I do a thing since I'm possessing the camera?
Yeah.
Is Jordan the one shooting?
No, Sarah's the one shooting.
I thought it was... Damn
it's
it,
a little
never
child.
Mind. If it was that's Jordan wild. Shooting, I was about to say, like, Minerva would, like, fucking yeet the camera, that way it misses.
I mean, you could technically shoot at the other camera.
She's Jordan, already a mess at the moment.
Minerva, Jordan has a laser.
Oh, shit. She's gonna, like, fucking, like, wildly shoot at Sarah. She's panicking.
6 damage.
Ah, Jesus.
I don't know what the hell. What the fuck to do, so just go back in the tuba and set the pipe man playing music.
Finding salvation in trumpet Jesus much once more.
The rabbit.
Oh, there goes raccoon.
The raccoon comes over and hangs down, upside down, looks at you.
Raccoon!
Well, they were touching, it would actually work! Fail to do something to it.
Is that all you want to do, Simba?
I'm also prepare another hype man action and skip my turn.
Okay. Minerva.
Is this a sword?
There certainly is something up there.
What the fuck is that?
Oh, Dad? yes! I know what that is. Mimi, what are you doing?
Christ fucking shit.
I don't mean to scare you, but I do mean to scare you.
I'm gonna shoot at Merlin, I guess.
Okay. Minerva. You see, quickly, rapidly, as you aim the camera over, something flies viciously towards you. and it starts to wave its hands back and forth in front of the camera incredibly quickly. It's trying to fan out the laser so it doesn't fly.
I'm curious, like, is it, like, right in front of the camera?
Right in front of it. It fans out the laser.
Oh, fun. Minerva's just gonna, like, go backwards. Just,
Are you having fun there?
No!
No, well, you took a shot. I thought you were having fun.
while we're over here, what is this?
Oh, the knife? It's a knife.
Okay. Oh god, it's a really big knife!
It's
not that big, but I just wanted you to see the knife.
It's a pretty big knife, Jesus Christ! Minerva's going out of Jordan and into the knife.
You have control of the knife.
Fuck yeah!
as you're leaving, the camera is just like, oh no, don't leave.
Sorry, I gotta go, not dying here, bye!
Not dying here, but
what's happening?
I'm gonna roll a brains roll for Merlin to see if Merlin knows where Dolly went. Can you? Yeah, you can spin a plot point to have it blow up. Yeah, give me a 2d6 for car explosion. Merlin's gonna jump backwards with his compression rocket boots.
Speedy as fuck.
Actually, no, I haven't used this one yet. Merlin's cloak comes out in front of him and forms an incredibly hard metal sheet.
Hackman! It's a big, ginormous explosion! What do you think, please? Epic explosive trumpet music!
And a d6 curly.
Blah, blah.
Merlin takes 1 damage, and some of the paint on his hat and cape flakes off. He turns and looks around, not knowing exactly where Dolly went.
Oh, now you've fucking done it, kid! You ruined my drip!
Poor, beautiful Magic Man.
Love my Magic Man. Magic Man is going to... he's gonna rocket boots into the air, and he's going to... Ah, fuck. Do I go for the kill on Ruth? Because, like, he totally could. Kat, what do you think?
Don't kill the clown!
Who's closer? I feel like he would look for Dolly.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'm first gonna give him a brains roll to try and find Dolly. Merlin can't find you.
Rip Merlin.
In frustration, he is going to randomly throw a rocket in one of 4 directions. 1 for over by Simba, 2 for over by Jordan, 3 for Ruth, 4 for absolutely by mistake hits Dolly.
And
2 goes over to Minerva. Minerva.
That means it also hits Jordan.
Yeah. You get this really nice knife, and then suddenly a fucking explosion.
Oh my god.
Fuck.
Hot damn.
You have resolve, Lab.
I only have 1!
You get the sensation that something's hiding under the ground right here.
What the fuck?
Just
try fucking... Can Once Upon December, like, quickly, like, throw out its arm and, like, make a big chunk of ice to, like, at least shield the knife a bit?
That seems reasonable.
Flick the bottom of the knife to, like, send it into the air a bit. The explosion is gonna happen underneath the knife, and it's gonna go flying at Merlin. Resolve Rush, then!
Hell yeah!
Hell yeah! Resolve Rush! All right. So 3d6.
3 additional d6 on top of that, yes.
Ah!
That is an 18.
Holy shit!
December redirects Minerva. Minerva, with the motherfucking knife, flies. Where are you aiming for?
The other eye that isn't broken.
Okay, you blind his other eye. Dealing 3 damage to Merlin, he's down to 5, and he lets out another scream of pain, which resounds around on the speakers still. Huh.
Minerva's just screaming as she flies through the air.
Holy hell. Merlin, with another fucking knife in his eyes, just stumbles staggering back around into the middle of the bumper car's room. Ruth! Ruth's car.
As he's in mid-air, how high is he up in the air?
I think I launched the guy like 90 feet in the air, so like roughly that far.
And Ruth, use this car and turn it into the biggest anvil impossible right over Merlin.
Yeah.
Like, he's going to town on this guy. With the biggest anvil he can manage. He's going to resolve rush!
Oh god, you're gonna squash Minerva!
Okay, if you're resolve rushing, I'm counter rushing. Merlin is going to foosh his cloak, open up his chest, and reveal 14 racks of anti-air missiles, and he's going to launch them at the anvil to blow it up midair!
Are you cheating me?
This is basically it. Nice playing with you guys.
I have 4 resolve left. I use all of them on this resolve rush.
Oh, fuck!
Okay, we do actually need to talk about this because you resolve rushed and he resolve rushed. If either of you die to this, you perish. Because neither of you have resolve left.
Minerva's in the middle of this!
Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
Can I use plot point? It's possible we have a psychic link. Ruth could use a plot point to be in another bumper car, touching the very tip of the blade to get it off into the windshield, driving away while the anvil is falling.
I'm actually okay with that. You want to say that you dove out of the anvil before it started falling?
Yep.
Yep.
And taking and helping to take Minerva out of the rain.
Alright. So the way I see this, Ruth, you're still going to roll your resolve rush. You'll still be out of resolve, but you dive into car, run over, the fucking car takes Minerva knife out of the way. And now, that's the success of the plot's point. You still gotta roll to actually damage him with the anvil. Cause that baby's fallen. Dear lord. It is a good thing. The anvil is blown to fucking smithereens! Merlin smirks to himself.
Bet that took you out, you damn mime.
Honk honk.
Oh, what the ever-living fuck!
Merlin turns to face the car that is honk honking.
It also has a knife.
Who gave the car a knife?
Gave the car a knife? Dolly!
Curly, what are you doing? You ragtime!
Into piano. Satellite the
Oh no!
Oh, that!
Oh no!
Huh?
You're gonna ragtime!
With a loud piano noise. The piano falls over. The top opens. An incredible noise comes out at Merlin, riveting through his bolts and parts, shaking his whole being to the core. Merlin! The stand! It puts up its arms! It's blocking, it's resisting, and then it just elbows Merlin in the head. And Merlin falls to bits. But
I fucking knew it, he's a ghost!
Yeah, Merlin turned himself into a ghost. To avoid the attack.
Ghost wrestling! Cause Jordan can't see ghosts, right?
Nope.
The Spectre just...
Well, meanwhile, Spectre's going like, crap, why? Why did you have to do this?
Yeah, Spectre's just gonna see a shit
this
show.
This was a calculated decision on my part. I should have known that he would have blown himself up eventually. There's a car that's moving on its own. There's Ruth, right?
Ruth is... Yeah, Ruth is a car with Minerva knife.
Does that stop a laser? I don't think so. Both of them are going to move this way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's their turn.
Makes sense. Okay.
I got it. Turn into the spoon!
Okay, you are the spoon.
Great to walk.
You just get bad at the robot.
Yep.
Oh, yes. Sarah blocks with the knife!
Knife!
Who gave this baby a knife?
Oh, you did.
Does that table mean that we're touching?
Yeah.
True, yeah.
That means I can talk to Spike.
Who is it now? Hello?
Oh, finally someone I can talk to. Hello there. Who are you exactly?
Who are you? You're the one that ran into me.
Simba Mseleku.
Oh, at least somebody who... Okay, you're not panicking unlike the other one. You may need to get a hold of the, I don't know what she is anymore. MiMi.
What?
MiMi is, like, panicking. She is not having a good time.
She's fine.
Understandable, he's in fact dead.
What do you want?
I want to know why you are attacking us.
I'm just watching. I'm not doing anything.
I'm not sure if you're lying or not.
If I were lying, I wouldn't be able to tell.
Am I attacking me? Because as far as I know, you're just attacking Amber.
You attacked my robot. My robot is fighting back. You have a technical connection because of Merlin. You want me to explain?
First of all, I never even attacked it.
It saw you as hostile. It's a work in progress. The VX9 series is a little wonky, to say the least.
Probably more than wonky.
You talk bad about my robots one more time, I'm going to gut you like a goddamn fish.
Oh god.
Actually, that's too nice. I will rip out your eyeballs, remove your trachea, make you breathe through a goddamn machine for 12 years as I experiment into special designed neurotoxins on you.
Oh,
suddenly, she feels menaced.
You sure that's
Spectre? You think you're so funny? You're so menacing. Oh no, whatever shall I do? Bitch, I will gut you. Roll me a fucking bravery check.
Yeah! Oh my god!
Intimidate Simba, do it.
Roll my regular bravery.
You're a spoon right now. How brave's a spoon, cat?
Give it, a 2. Simba, let's just say the menace is overpowering.
Is this possible? Simba is menacing me even more! They're not usually menace.
The Spectre goes quiet.
Minerva.
Yeah.
Minerva knife.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to convince Merlin to try to possess the park.
How are you going to do that?
Like, my main idea was to try to use Once Upon December to feeling of getting the fuck out of here, into the grounds, possess the park.
Are you gonna fucking Angelo him? I swear to god.
It still has fear. Music box is down here. Yeah, can Once Upon December just sneakily rewind that and just yeet?
Just throws it into the middle ring? Yeah, of course.
Just chucks it. Minerva, very quickly, is going to mumble the roof. I don't have the capacity to block your ears right now, but ignore what you're about to feel. And it's gonna put the... gonna make a feeling of more panic, but also, just generally less, much less panic, like, downwards as a sense of, like, oh, this must be safe.
You want the whole world but the floor to appear safe, yeah?
No.
Or
the
other way
floor
around.
To be
yes, 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 yes. Sorry, I misspoke. Yes, okay, cool.
Yeah. He can.
Actually, you're totally right. He can. No, you're totally right. He's not possessing anything currently. You're totally right.
Oh, fuck.
If this does at least, 5 damage to him, he dies.
Oh shit!
Or see dies. I'm going to improv this. That
your fate shall be decided by the rat.
Uh huh. Give me a moment. So, let me drop the music for this. I'm pretty sure you got him here. The music box. starts to play. Merlin, in a moment of panic, dives into the floor and possesses it. As he's down there, he starts chuckling to himself as Madam Mim begins to reform, and he says,
"Those foolish kids, they won't be able to get me if I'm the entire park! I could be so many things. The roller coaster, the stalls, the pavement, the asphalt, the hot dogs, the burgers, the buns!"
His mind, it starts spinning. Every single possibility of what he could be flying through his head as Merlin's consciousness spreads into the entire park. And Madam Mim just kind of drifts there, aimlessly floating. It's not dead. It's just mentally dead. End of combat, and as the stand's effect fades, all of you are no longer ghosts, but realize that under some sort of effect, you were exactly where you were when you were first hit.
Oh, that's
unconscious. Your heads hurt like hell. You see down in the middle, as you start to more or less wake up, Madam Mim just kind of lists through the air like a balloon. The raccoon bats at it.
Catching the stand with him on.
You catch her. She's completely limp.
Shit. I guess that worked as intended.
Her eye blinks once, then the other eye. She looks down at you.
The buns.
Okay, what do we do with a brain dead stand?
Riff painfully just flops over the railing onto the ground. He looks very bad shape.
December, I wasn't dead. Would have disappeared if I was, I think, maybe, probably.
Is that a Dolly tackle hug I see?
Yeah. Oh. Oh god. Oh god.
Oh god.
Oh no. This is an army.
Are you gonna oh god. Minerva's gonna get murdered by hugs. Jesus Christ. He's gonna try to keep a hold on the stand. That way it doesn't fucking fly off.
Madam Mim blinks. It, like, drunkenly smiles. It hugs you too.
That's weird.
What the heck is happening? Oh no, Dolly.
Oh, Dolly. Oh.
You all gather yourselves, and as you all feel the exhaustion sneak in, you see and hear buzzing. And shoes tapping.
Oh god!
And then you see them.
What? No!
And look at the CR!
What is that bizarre field?
Jesus Christ!
They point to the robot's fan out. I need to collect the body and the crystal and these fine people.
Ruth, with little strength he has left, looks at everyone, looks at the robots. There's no other way to get out of this situation but the one trick.
No, I'll do it. I'll do it. Thank you very much. The Simba just looks at this situation and goes like, I know one technique, I only know one way to solve this problem.
Listen, I'm going to interrupt your monologue right now because, dear lord. You can't get out!
With the cage, I doubt that we have a way out. I would not...
There is one way out.
I would not recommend...
Unless you want to be turned... Unless you want your feet turned into the goddamn cement, I suggest you don't try to run!
Right.
Painfully brings that aside. what you want from us.
Ruth! Simba! Stop! Now.
Oh, Mimi.
How the fuck? Hello. Do you know that name? I'm guessing you might have heard it from Dolly.
Listen, I have ears all over the goddamn park. And I was watching you. Listen, Cloud9 is already annoyed at you guys, so it was my turn to fuck with you. I hope you liked Merlin. He was part of the XV9 series.
He's kind of nice.
I know he is. I need to fix the personality. I also need to take care of her. I did not think you would do that much mental damage to a robot. I'm quite impressed. Now, if you will all stop your sniveling. You're going to come with me. Any objections?
We don't have much. This place is engaged. There's nothing.
What will happen if we go with you?
Oh, nothing. I will just lock you up in some cells, ask you some questions. Cloud9 will probably ask you some questions as well. You may lose some fingers. May gain some new superpowers. You know, the usual.
Oh. I already know what my decision I'm going to make.
And what is that?
Mediocre!
So fucking fleek?
Yep!
Hold on.
You yell. Spectre holds out a hand. You see a blue glow envelop their hand. And your feet fuse to the metal.
Mommy!
That's why I told you all to calm down.
Ruth, knowing there's no way out of this situation, he can't combat a stand that does this. He's outnumbered, but then he realized something. He looks at the stand, and then looks at Minerva and Dolly. Ruth pulls out the mask towards them.
No options here. I'm going to simply ask you, Spectre. You're planning on taking all of us with you, correct?
Yes, that is the plan.
Rather not stop this fuck. There's no options.
You're all stand users. You're all very interesting. Most of you have red tickets. Other than the one who tried to flee, but you know, I would have actually just let him go if he hadn't tried to run.
Sorry.
The intelligence of the normal person is baffling to me every day.
If we worked with you peacefully, would you not harm us? Because I'd rather...
I won't harm you as much. I will let you recover first, of course. I need to do it in prime condition. Though, I only want to mess with a few of you.
Fuck it! I'm using a learning point. I'm going to use one learning point, and, Tali?
Mm-hmm.
Once upon a December's getting up substand.
Ah, you're doing this one. I love that one.
Yes. I think I have my idea. Essentially, I don't know what body part it will be connected to yet, but its whole thing is that it is called In the Dark of the Night. Its its ability is that when it shows itself to someone, they hallucinate themselves in the worst nightmare imaginable that they could ever be in. Their worst fears, their worst noises, the worst sights, everything horrendous. It affects everyone who sees it. Once upon a December, Minerva panicking in the situation, trying to figure out a way out, we're literally in a cage, specters everywhere. The thing that's gonna happen does not look good. No other options but to grow. And once upon a December, just seeing Minerva's panic, knowing exactly what's happening, everything is bleak. It's something strange forms inside of it. It's ice, not exactly. It's something horrendous, terrifying. Anyone who sees it or even is nearby can tell that it's something remarkably nasty, distorted, something that should not be of this world. And once upon a December, fucking chucks it, like, right here. And it shatters into a indescribable monster, giving madness to anyone who sees it. Minerva, in that moment, fucking of instinct, closed her eyes and tried to look away, pulling Dolly behind her to make sure that she didn't get affected either. She can't do much about Ruth or Simba.
Yeah, he's not paying attention.
Yeah.
Yeah, your instincts will naturally scream at you that this is not something that you should look at.
You throw it towards Spectre, right? It lands on the ground, it shatters.
Yes.
Minerva, I will tell you two things. Three things, actually.
Oh, God.
One, you've activated a villainous action.
Fuck.
Two, you've activated a trait. And three, Spectre stares willingly into the visage.
Oh, God damn.
The villainous action you've set off is called "And They Got Busy."
What?
It is this one, hell yeah.
Yep. If an opportunity arises where this is funny, that was actually the wording.
Love it.
This is my favorite villainous action.
Oh my god.
And it's essentially a blue beam of ice, or like what looks like ice forming and unforming in the span of a millisecond, fires from Spectre's finger. It encases the visage, whatever you threw at her, them. But it also, her other finger points at you and Once Upon a December, and you're essentially suspended in air and in time.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no, no, no. And she lifts you up. What were you think you were doing?
Is Minerva still able to think in this state?
You can think. You can move your eyes. You can't talk.
Yeah, she's just staring at Spectre in a lot of panic. And
that was a nice try. Though what I saw, I have already done to myself.
Shit. God damn it.
Now I would think it's a good idea if you come with me.
Ruth looks at Minerva and Dolly and Simba. It would be futile to fight this woman without knowing what she's capable of doing.
Thank you, this is literally your only option.
Ruth stands up carefully, puts up his arms like he's surrendering. Then, with a sudden quick reflection, vanishes with everyone as he pulls them into a door.
Give me a speed roll.
Work.
No, it's literally welded.
Ruth, I will give you an option. You can put one person through the door, Dolly or yourself.
Knowing he doesn't have much of a chance, looks at Dolly. He then hands her something in a piece of cloth and shove her through that door, closing it.
Dolly's gone.
Dolly sent somewhere.
Oh my god. Dolly!
Cheeky. I appreciate that. You're smart. Now,
Spectre will set Minerva and Once Upon a December down. She's... any other requests?
Is she still frozen or is she not
no,
frozen?
No, you're unfrozen.
Ah, great. Minerva just kind of shakingly just takes a half step, not in any particular direction, just more steadying herself. I'm guessing the stand is still, like, grappled to Minerva, because it's just kind of been there.
Yeah, she's just hugging you. She's drunk on being the whole park.
Shit.
Riff still has his arms up. He's defeated.
All right. Time to go.
She waves a hand and Simba can walk. I'm not going to chain you up unless you really want to be chained up, but that's just kinda kinky.
We'll have to figure this out. I'm assuming you're all capable of walking.
Mm-hmm. Ruth holds his side.
Yeah. Don't worry, it won't be a long stay. Soon enough, you'll be somewhere else. Or I'll keep you as pets. Who knows?
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh, Jesus.
Map time is done.
Yeah, did you time? Did you like plan all of this to happen?
Oh my god, what is happening?
Yeah, that was what I said.
There's a mouse or a rat.
Team B found the roaming boss.
They found the rat.
Oh, shit!
I mean, like, it's a secret action I had.
Oh, rip.
Nice to know that my prediction of Team A fucking dying was correct.
And I think it's time to do some art.
Yeah.
Yay! My emotional state of being is literally beyond fucked.
Oh my god! What a fucking episode! That was a time.
Things have escalated so quickly.
I just realized something.
Yeah, what's that?
Well, we just get to reveal Spectre art. It's my favorite.
Oh yeah. So for starters, Warden.
I will put Devil.
Devil.
They're all so cute.
I'm going to post Mother Memes? Robot. Oh, what are these small ones? Let's do these small ones first. I love these small ones. Yeah. Them!
Who gave the baby the knife?
Why does the snake camera have a whisk at its tail?
It's a microphone.
Oh,
I thought it was a whisk.
It's not a whisk, it's a microphone. It's not a whisk! and then we got Merlin and Madame Mim, who Madame Mim is now bound to the park and is fucking aloof and drunk, and I love that. You fucking merged a robot with the universe.
I didn't. I guess.
Here they are. You did.
It's just the image of very tired and very image party with Madame Mim of like. Rings are like stuck up to Minerva.
Yeah, so you guys took on a rank 3. Of course, it's going to be difficult.
Rank 4 is going to be extremely difficult for us, isn't it?
You don't have a rank 4, you have an unknown rank.
Team
B has a rank 4.
They're gonna die in their rank 4.
Dolly may show up there.
Dolly is gonna be somewhere. We gotta talk about that out of this call, Kat. Yeah. Spectre?
MiMi, I'm going to tell you 3 things.
Yeah. And they got busy.
And they got... I shouldn't say it
that. But we all know.
We all know.
Let me put up John Science, aka Spectre. I love that Duncan named this John Science.
John Science, oh my god.
There they are.
Oh, they're terrifying. Oh,
goddammit. That was the episode, guys. I hope you had a good time.
Oh my god, Team B is going to have a hell of a time next time when Dolly shows up.
If Dolly shows up,
we gotta figure out how that's gonna work out. When you guys see what fucking Team B did, it is a... It's a trip.
When does that come out?
Oh boy.
Whenever I get it done. I don't know. We got a lot of backlog. I don't know when it's coming up. We can work on it. I want to put it out on a Friday, is my thought, so that we can get...
Yeah, we can prefer it. Yay. Especially because we have so much fucking strings.
Uh-huh. We could free barter.